and we have a whole day ahead of us. So I want to thank Professor John for this excellent initial presentation. Thank you.
Thank you. And sorry for my difficulty to understand some questions.
And I invite all the participants to have tea and also spend time with Santosh's excellent capture. One of the first, I think we need to give him a hand just to start the session. Thank you. Professor John, you want to comment? Yeah? You want to visit the chart? You want to have a look?
Yeah, I have no time. Yeah.
Okay. Anybody who has worked in a hospital, if somebody asks them, what is the product that you produce, it is very difficult to answer that question. And the entire idea of case mix for over close to 30 years now has evolved in chasing that primary question which Rob Fetter had in mind. Now, essentially what we understand as healthcare professionals is the idea of diagnosis, which actually translates into a case type. Now, how do you take that and use it for different purposes, which in the previous lecture, Professor Jean so beautifully said, taking the concept, generalizing it in use, and localizing the tool. I think that's a very important advice he has given the forum here. The next lecture dwells a little more, building upon those concepts which we have listened to in the previous lecture. He will go into the details of how case mix analysis is carried out. I invite Professor John to give this lecture. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you for to attend this second presentation. And the timing becoming better for me. For now, it's 7 a.m. in Europe, so better than 4 a.m. So I'm going to see a little bit more in detail case mix analysis, and I have two co-authors. I have to present for I use their material. One is Terry Jackson from Australia in Melbourne. She is a senior researcher and she is particularly interested in the use of data needed for case mix, but to be used for quality of care measurement. And I will show some things that which are very interesting when you have done this data, you can use them for funding, for management, but you can as well have a view on the quality very easily when you have the data, of course, very easily on the quality of care. And that, I think, is probably a little bit underestimated. And then Jugnasha, as you probably think, she was born in India, and she's an American citizen, and she is working mainly in the United States on the prospective payment system for outpatient. I don't think she is an Indian citizen, and I am nearly sure she doesn't speak Hindi. But she speaks better English than me. So, doing this introduction, we are going. So, what can be done with case mix? That's an important question. It's good to have codes diagnostic, to have codes the data, to have taken a software to produce DRG, even to have produced length of stay by DRG or cost by DRG, but why? To do what? And I think what is in red is the most important sentence. It is a shift, a change in paradigm from what health services are doing to patient or user, you see, side, or the supply side on the, you see, professional, and then from to what the patient user is receiving from them in relation to his or her health problems. You see, it seems a little bit technical, but in fact, it is a real shift, a view, starting from the supply side to go to the demand side. For at the level of the healthcare professional, a lot of things are known. We know their salary, we know the days they work, we can know a lot of things, okay? But this, until you move to case mix system, is not related to what the patient receives. For we don't, without the case mix, we don't characterize the patient. We don't know who is he, okay? And so I have just proposing three main use. One, the funding payment. I will start with this one, but I will not elaborate too much. And then the internal management, including the quality. And then epidemiology and health economics, knowledge acquisition, for it is really related to the patient demands and needs of care. So, case mix seeks to hold healthcare organization accountable for cost and quality, but what is important, controlling for patient variation, which can be said in another way, adjusted for the mix of care. That is the big, big, big difference. And refocus on the so-called product of hospital care, the treating patient, and not individual services. And Robert Fetter was calling that intermediate product. So it's a very famous scheme explaining, you see, the input. Of course, it's a very health economics vocabulary. But inputs, intermediate output, and product. Okay? And the input, capital, hospital-based equipment, labor, pharmacist, pathologist, nurse, you see, these inputs are well known since a long time. Then they produce what is named intermediate output, patient bed days, x-ray, lab test, meals, a lot of things. And this, until this, is reasonably known, you see, since it's not too difficult. The shift is between the intermediate product and the product, intermediate output, and then the product. So you see, for instance, for a vaginal delivery without complication, for a kidney transplant, for Lenz procedure, for appendectomy without complicated principal diagnostic, etc., etc., we are going to use all these intermediate outputs. And you see, apparently they are the same, except that they must be merged in a different way. You don't need the same thing for all these. All these are DRG groups, different DRG groups. You take that, but you see, not the same things. And that is what can be called a medical production function. The first one is a typical production function. We have input and we have output, okay? And then, this different intermediate output, we take some, and of course, the list is the same, but each group is not using the same amount of each. You see? That's the main idea of the case mix system. Yes.
No. So what you're saying is like, because I can give an example, just as a hypothetical situation, if I were putting up on my website a hospital, they do it right now, that's what hospitals do. At least they're doing that. Basically, they advertise, they have something called a scorecard, mm-hmm. even though that word scorecard is not used in the right way. Mm-hmm. And I thought I was excited, I thought they're going to show us the outcomes. But instead what they have done is they have claimed we have done, say if you look at the scorecard for the Department of Nephrology or Urology, mm-hmm. it would say 3,500 transplants. Mm-hmm. So when they make that statement, they are still working on some nascent idea of a case mix.
Yeah.
Basically.
Yeah.
But what you're pointing out to is that in each of these categories which is there, for example, vaginal delivery with complications, and maybe vaginal delivery with complications, the inputs and intermediate outputs used will automatically be likely to be different. Is that what you're...
Yeah, yeah, that's different. For instance, in the DRG, vaginal delivery without complication exists, but there is another group for vaginal delivery with complication. Okay? And of course, the amount of lab test, the amount of imaging, the amount of nursing care is not the same. You see? And so that is why it is really a shift, okay? Even the number of patient bed days at the length of stay, we know that, okay? It is not so difficult to do all the X-ray done, but what is interesting is to know which type of X-ray have been done for vaginal delivery without complication and how much has been done for vaginal delivery with complication, you see? And for the transplant, the nephrology department, for the transplant, I need to know, and I will know, the number of X-rays, the number of lab tests, the number of nursing care, okay? And of course, will be different for dialysis, for instance, and so on, you see? That's the main idea. And of course, it changed a lot. We move to things which can be understood. Before case mix, you cannot understand what is going on in healthcare system. That's
So if this idea, when you compare to other industries, is so commonsensical, why did it take so much time to first invent this idea? Why are countries like India, you know, still sleeping over it or dreaming about it? What do you think is the...
I think the main characteristic is that, of course, this is a conceptualization, okay? And I will say, even if it's not true, conceptualization is easy, and realization is less easy. And you can do these things. And in fact, you have, I think, starting in the 60s, in books and things, you have some people having said more or less the same thing. The question is that Bob Fetter has done the job. And why he has done the job? For he has been able to have database. That means that he has had informatics, IT resources. And you see, to explain why it doesn't came before, is that it started, he received the contract with the federal government in 67, 2 years after the Medicare Act was passed by the Johnson administration. And he worked, I think, 3 years, and then realized he did find some database with the Federation